Team Dignitas now finds themselves in the exact place their rivals did in the first semifinal of today, down the first game. But this is a best of five, and there are plenty of chances to get back in.
Yeah, for sure. But I'm still, again, like from the get-go after yesterday, I looked at this match and I was just like, that is going to be a lot harder than I expected. Now they lost the first map. Again, there is a lot of pressure. And Miracle, you could see, like, they are cheery, they're happy, they're hungry, they get the momentum right now. And at some point, we have to ask the same question that we asked with Gen.G. Is there that voice of doubt in your head that asks, like, oh God, what happens if we lose right now?
I think it's cool, though, that both Miracle and Team Liquid said, why are we facing these ridiculously strong opponents in the semifinals, but then they're also both bringing the fight. That is what's awesome to see. And I don't think Dignitas is going to lie down just yet. Let's see where we're going for game two and where they might be able to make a stand happen. It's going to be Volskaya Foundry. This is a place that Dignitas also finds home in, though Team Dig has chosen first pick, so it's Miracle who will bring us to Volskaya Foundry.
Now you got to be feeling confident, especially when you look at the record of Dignitas on this battleground. They are pretty darn solid here, so let's see if Miracle can bring that out. But one person in particular that I feel like Dignitas needs to adjust to and keep an eye on is Sniper. Sniper was finding so many ways to thread that needle, getting that back line. He was able to pick on Poik, but if he's allowed to do that throughout the entire best of five series, we could have an upset on our hands.
You mentioned that during that league play, they were 12-1. They played this map 13 times during league play. Their next highest map played was 7. They are masters at this battleground at controlling. We always know the Sergeant Hammer could potentially come out. Some of the sustained damage that we've seen from Frankel, they have busted out the Mephisto on this one as well. So it does have a different feel when you look at sustain between those heroes. It's just a matter of, can you sneak in that hammer? Can you get it late? Are you worried about your opponents getting that? Can you draft? And I think when you look at this battleground, Sergeant Hammer has been a focal point for a very long time.
Well, in the last game, Ural did become contested in a very weird way with a triple warrior of sorts for Miracle. I'm wondering how highly prioritized Dignitas puts that hero, or Miracle 2, given the fact that they really like this hero here. But with the Diablo changeup ban, that allows Genji through, and Team Dig are quick to strike.
There's also what we saw Arcana play earlier today, the Tracer, if that is an option for these teams. The Tracer is always very threatening in and around the control points, as long as you have the team built around it.
The Genji is definitely something that Miracle absolutely expected here. The snap picks into Reyna and Deckard Cain, getting the zone control again. We talked in the previous series of how highly we have Reyna valued by the Korean teams here. But it's also, again, for me personally, really interesting to see it, how both of them agree, okay, we're going to ban out Garrosh and Diablo. We've seen a little bit of that in the group stage. So what's the focus here? Dignitas shifts away from the Anub'arak, goes into Johanna. Great pick here for them. And they combo that off with the Blaze on the off lane. And Blaze, in general, in Europe, gets so much more value on this particular map that that doesn't really come as a surprise, despite how much we talked about Ural as an option for them.
Johanna, in North America at least, we saw a lot of Johanna Jaina together, and with a Genji, there's a lot of burst potential for just taking down someone in the blink of an eye. Maybe that's a pick that we could see from Team Dignitas?
The Johanna Blaze is always has nice synergy, because it's really easy to land the Condemn, have the follow-up with the Blaze there to get the stun that is kind of denied from you. It's only a mini stun with the Condemn. Is we're going to see the Jaina banned out there, but Genji picked up. Genji also at one point in time was a counter. It's like, look, if you're going to pick Hammer, well, the Genji, if it's let through, it's one of those things that you can dive onto that. But that also is something that you can still get the Hammer if you're Dignitas.
Not anymore.
Except it's banned.
Yeah.
That's also a great ban by them. I mean, we've been talking the entire time about how these Protect the Hammer compositions are just so powerful. We just had one on Towers of Doom, and now you have Blaze with that, so you want to make sure that that's not going to be a concern. But again, Ural picked up for the other side, and together with Tyrael. And just think about Gen.G versus Team Liquid. We've seen that particular setup several times. It's starting to really have an impact here. And Miracle is now using the exact same tools.
What is Poik going to play? Is he going to be Li Ming here?
Well, I love when they used to play Genji, Hanzo together.
Dope, there's that Tracer coming out here
there
with Malfurion for the pick.
But think about this. I was about to say, man, Genji, you look over there. Every time there's a Tyrael on the other side, you're like, who's going to stop me? There's no CC unless you're going Judgment. We all know that's not happening. Tracer, the same thing. I mean, Tracer, there is no threat. The Hammer stun that you're worried about, she does have trouble trading out head-to-head with Rainer.
Yeah.
But you still, with Malfurion pickup, this is Dignitas. They used to run this back in January, December, when they went on their early run, as we'll see the Thrall there. That can help poke out against the Tracer, but that Tracer now can run rampant in this game.
All right, Team Dignitas are doubling down, Genji and Tracer, to bring the aggression. It's been a while since I've seen Poik's Tracer.
Yeah.
But he made a name for himself on that Tracer.
Yeah, first of all, but like I was still, I think the Thrall is a great pick for the last choice here, because you can, with the Chain Lightning, just start to just poke Tracer down quite a bit. Then you have Rainer too. Yes, you are lacking that CC that you normally want to go up against her, but having those two combined, that can still hurt a lot. And if you don't pay attention, you are dead immediately.
Trick, what are you feeling there?
I think Dignitas has got this one.
Okay.
A lot of kill potential. I think every time that I've doubted a Genji and a Tracer together, I always bite my words later on, because there's like 20 kills after in a match. I think they have enough aggression available, and they have the ability to back up too with that bunker coming in.
There's just a whole lot of self-sustain plus the armor of Urel. Is it enough to punch through?
It's always going to be a matter of Blaze. You mentioned it previously. Blaze is like, okay, we're confirming a kill. You drop down that bunker, you get the pulse bomb. They will all in on one target. Sanctification is a very good counter to that. So I think that does help, but it's a matter of, do you get enough sustain? Because Genji and Tracer, they are sustained. You don't have the CC to stop that. So you get more sustain than normal, but you do get poked out, as Kaldor said, from the Thrall and the Rainer. So I think you have the ability to be aggressive, but I really like the draft from Miracle. I think two teams with great drafts here.
Both good drafts, but it's Miracle who is currently leading the charge 1-0. We'll see if Team Dignitas can tie it up on Volskaya Foundry.
Kettle War, Dignitas down 0-1. Miracle showing that they belong here at BlizzCon, but are they going to go up 2-0 against Dig?
I think they have what it takes here. They have the potential at least, but Dignitas is of course very confident in especially Poik's abilities now to dance around them and get these kills. I feel also that Thrall has to be an absolute focus point here when we're talking about potential targets. Who else are you going for? You have Rain, of course, in that back line, but can you really just like move on to him and trade into that? Thrall, oftentimes, when he oversteps a bit too much, presents a really good target for a quick kill.
And if we're going to have that Crash Lightning we've been seeing so much from Sniper, you want to jump on him and clear him up before he gets stacked up. But here we go. On the left side, on the blue, it's going to be JPL on Johanna, bringing that wave clear. Wubby here with the bunkers to save his team. Poik going to be playing Tracer, Snitch on Genji. And finally, Zhelia on Malfurion. Give up your energy. It is Team Dignitas.
And with a lead in this series, in this best of five, Sniper on Thrall. We're seeing Frankel on the auto attack with Jim Rayner, Najajin on Urel, Blue Beetle on Deckard Kane, and Judy on Tyrion. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Miracle!
And it is going to be that Crash Lightning. Dignitas instantly responds to it. He sees them spread out here to make sure they don't give off any stacks. Dignitas jumps up and goes for the wave clear, which is what Johanna brings his composition, while Poik starts working on those pulse bombs.
Tyrael has been an absolutely amazing force in the semifinals so far, and he is picked up again by Miracle here with a very melee-heavy composition. You get the extra armor, 3 Urel, you have the shields that you yourself provide, and then Thrall is always going to be at your side for that poke with damage. And it creates space. It creates a lot of space for Rainer in the back line.
Dignitas going for aggressive play here. Menachogen is going to sidestep that root coming out, and he's able to survive. But Dignitas trying to play with fire here and get their first kill. Beautiful play there by Urel.
Snitch and Poik are really the two that need to make this happen for them right now. The mobility that we're seeing on those two heroes, the ability to collapse onto a backline target and take it apart is what's heavily needed here for Dig to tie this series leading into the third game. But Miracle, of course, has very different plans here. They already took the lead after game number one. If they can make 2-0 happen, that would be fantastic for their chances to go up against Genji in the grand final.
And those kills will be easier too for Genji at level 4 when he gets that Swift Strike, extra damage at the end of the tip there. So we should be seeing that from Snitch soon, and that comes at a point where the control point will be coming in. Now, the next thing that we need to focus on is the support camp, and you see both teams dancing around. Everyone is fully aware of what this can provide if you're able to take it.
And Blue Beetle already has the potions ready, immediately setting this up because he knows this might be where we're going to have the first big fight. And you see the offlaner starting to focus a little bit more towards the middle of the map. Miracle has just pushed out the bot lane, so they're making the rotation. But it's the mid lane that everyone's focusing on. So far, there's no commitment to the support camp.
Dignitas can start it there. They have a pulse bomb ready, and that idea of just starting the fight so you get the pulse bomb off and try and force your opponent into an engage that they do not want to have is something they can pull off. They just need to get Blaze to rotate over. And speaking about that, Blaze is actually on his way as he is currently in the middle lane.
Strangling Vines also taking on Malfurion. We've seen this also a bit in the semifinal already, making sure that you have less healing on the target. Crest Talons coming in galore, by the way, with a Frostwolf pack now chosen on Thrall. Definitely something that we see a lot more, especially out of Korean teams.
Something that Sniper really finishes quickly, too. We did it yesterday on BOE. Remember, we had an 80k damage game. The next person behind him was down at 38k. This guy knows how to play Thrall and push him to his limit. Dignitas starting to look at this point here as Miracle does the same.
This is actually a great position for Miracle because they can stack those Crash Lightning on Thrall. That's super important for him here to get a couple more of these hits in. And right now he's sitting at 5 stacks already.
Sitting at 5 and more should come. Wubby comes in with the Jet Propulsion. They go straight for a combo, looking straight at Naja Jin. Urel trying to escape, misses the full disengage, and here comes Genji.
Well done, Dignitas going in deep for this one. The final hit by Ablaze, but especially Snitch's play here, super important. There's just no chance to escape. The shots, the hits keep coming from every single angle.
And Poik doing the small things here. He gets in the face of Urel, immediately blinks back the last second, and that's why you saw that big hammer miss out on the full engage, and that allowed for Genji to come in and finally get that kill. Dignitas finds one, takes a support camp, and already has the lead on the control point, sitting at a total of 40%.
And Dignitas loves to play from this position. They have played this map in the regular season 13 times and only lost once against the leftovers. Outside of that, Dignitas is just looking great here. And they are now in that position where that healing beacon is giving them the upper hand in the fight over the first protector here. Miracle goes in, Bomb comes out, then triple strike, goodbye Thrall, he's gone, and Dignitas is looking powerful here.
You have to be careful against Ablaze. That three-man stun, you had Poi come in from behind, jump straight on top of Thrall, stopping those Crash Lightnings in their track. At the same time, Dignitas can now make an aggressive play for the turret, and they take another item for the map.
And the kill, of course, also reset the stacks that we already saw in the Frostwolf back force. Sniper, so that's another big part here. 9 stacks on the Crash Lightning, we're gonna keep a close eye on that. It's especially threatening Tracer with a poke, but right now Dignitas is looking powerful. Level lead, going to the top side, trying to take down the fountain at least, and in the meantime, splitting will be down to the bottom of the map to grab even more experience.
Yeah, textbook play here from Dignitas. Sometimes we've been seeing an adjustment to push in that middle 4 and try and get that big experience, but yeah, Rainer with that nice single target DPS damage. You just want to go for that well and make sure you're set up for the next control point on the top side. Now, Dignitas, one of the best things they do with the Protector is they are so good at finding a target and blowing it up. Their teamwork is huge, and they're looking for another pick, and there it is as Jimmy goes down.
He does not only go down, he doesn't even drop the turret.
Thrall
also falls here. Miracle is not getting a foothold in this game anytime soon. The turret dropped and immediately picked up by Tracer, then Thrall falls as well. Dignitas with 4-0 and more than a level lead is looking stellar in game 2.
You have to be so careful against the Protector because this happens. You suddenly fall so behind. 1 level and a half in favor of Team Dignitas. They are close to level 10. And with that level 10, they have a couple of options. Take down that middle 4, get more experience as well, try to look for some kills, or just simply keep taking away items.
The next few minutes are going to be just horrible for Miracle. They're going to be sitting in the spot where they know that Dignitas is going to look for an engage. Dignitas will be willing to dive behind forts with this to look for even more kills. They have the mobility through Tracer and Genji, of course, so they are going to see if they can maybe pick up another kill here, maybe go for that Thrall again, but at least destroy a couple of the structures on the map.
Yeah, Miracle just needs to weather this storm, get towards that level 10, get that signification online so they can actually handle the onslaught coming in from Team Dignitas, but Dignitas should be taking the rewards now, pushing in the middle lane. And if things get hairy too, remember they still have 4 items here. They can drop a turret down to completely focus down this fort, or if Miracle somehow gets the engage they want, they still have the extra DPS.
Their item advantage is ridiculous at this point.
They got 4 right now. They're all set up. I don't even know if Blaze has something on the bottom, but I wouldn't be surprised there if Blaze had an item as well. Dignitas just knows how to run this battleground.
At some point, you have to start destroying them just simply because you can't hold anything.
Yeah, you throw down a turret.
Yeah, you have to drop the turret and just simply waste it because you don't want to give it over to your opponent, because right now Dignitas is in just the best spot ever for the next objective in particular.
And there's that answer. Blaze has that turret. Another combo straight in and boom, there goes Thrall.
We talked about it. They dive behind the fort. They go in. They have the mobility. They drop Thrall and they go for the fort.
And they drop a turret because you know what's spawning right now? Another turret in the bottom right corner.
Yep.
Miracle's turret's up and Dignitas beeline straight over for it.
You need an inventory for those heroes and heroes on the storm, so they can hold 2, 3.
Their stock value is definitely going up pretty darn heavily here for Team Dignitas, and they're building towards that 13 too. Miracle finally hits 10. So, okay, we've made it to 10. We've got Heroics now. Miracle only 2 levels behind, but still in the same talent tier. I'm more curious to see if we're going to get that Sundering in from Thrall. It's been a mean go-to for Sniper, but we've seen some adjustments here and there by a lot of teams.
But what do we usually see on this map? If you lose the first Protector, you're focusing your attention towards the second objective. You know that your opponent is going to hit the early level 13, so you have to give a bit of that progress over to them. But then, throughout half of it, you normally can engage into it with the same talent. I don't see that happening for Miracle here. They, first of all, don't have the top fountain anymore. They have no item control. And at this point, they are also having nearly no chance of getting 13. They need to team fight ideally now, and they need to get some kills from somewhere. If they fall too far behind after another Protector, I don't see them recovering.
They set up the fight here. Remember, there are 3 turrets here for Dignitas. Dignitas steps up. The control point being used here on the top side. Urel on the back line.
This is the chance. 13 isn't there yet. This is the best fight you're going to get, Miracle. Sanctification is on the ground. They're looking for the kill. The bunker is there. Ooh. The X strike to the face. Snitch with the triple kill.
Incredible play by both Wubby and Snitch. Wubby set up that death propulsion to hit 3, and immediately Snitch jumped out, dropped down the X-ray, and got multiple kills at once. Miracle loses 4, loses out on the biotic emitter, and also starts to lose out on the control point. Let's check that out one more time.
Look at that X-strike. Genji Snitch with a play completely racking
Miracle.
Look at
the bunker dancing. The bunker dancing here is so important. They both jump into it, but immediately Wubby jumps out, go for the jump potion, boom, there it is. And here's the X strike for the killing blow.
A brutal play.
Dignitas keeping up with the brutality here in the top lane, continuing to control items, already working on that keep wall. Dignitas is setting up again for a killing blow. We saw this on Infernal Shrines and Miracle defended against it, but can they hold against a Protector?
It's going to be extremely difficult, especially since there's even more experience going to land in your lap if Dignitas grabs the objective now. I'm just still impressed by Snitch here. I mean, that was absolutely devastating. Just from a psychological perspective, Miracle sitting there and getting completely wrecked by Genji. Keep in mind, we saw a similar play already earlier when Wubby landed that triple jet propulsion, and then we saw Genji just darting in, dishing out the damage, and it led to several kills for Dignitas. Currently, you can tell Snitch, he wants this. He's saying like, nope, I'm not going to go out 0-2 in here and have to enter the third map being so far down. We are going to take this one, and then we are going to break them.
Sniper just so low on health already. A Pulse Bomb comes out and some damage from Wubby 2 to for good measure. Didn't even have the glove connected. The glove connected from Dignitas. That would have certainly been a kill.
Yeah.
Dignitas taking the time here to shred down this keep while Miracle sets up for defense. They're trying to go towards 13, but they have to hold firm.
Urella's still topside. They're trying to get experience there. They want 13 at least. They need some XP and need it soon. But Dignitas, of course, they want the keep, and Miracle is very well aware that they have no chance of actually holding it. They're just to try and delay it, burn that Punisher down, burn the Protector down to make sure that there is no way for Dignitas to end.
There is good news for Miracle. We got 18 stacks there for Thrall, building up the Crash Lightning, so things are still building up for them as they continue to get that damage propped up. With 3 level deficit, it's certainly starting to hurt, but Miracle is no stranger to this. We saw them earlier be behind and turn around the game completely. Wubby goes in for engage, but Tyrael dodges it as Judy sets up the play.
And now Wubby is in trouble. It was great play by Judy, but can they get the kill there? Jet Propulsion moves out. Frostwolf pack completed, and an item on the ground as we are stealing a healing beacon, helping out Blaze.
Hoyt did one thing that was really brilliant. Jumped into the back line and made sure to say, hey, look at me. That allowed time for Blaze to get away after the bunker. Use a jump potion to completely escape. But Miracle still showing they got some fight left in them. They're actually coming down here this turret to fight.
They're going for the turret. Dignitas is saying, boys, let's take a deep breath in.
Yeah.
We're so close to 16. Why would we give them a fight on 13 talents? There is zero reason. Let them have the turret. We go to the left side, take our own. We will have a 3-level lead, the 16 talent advantage, and then we play around that. There's no need to make it easy for them to come back into the game.
Especially when we're considering that Holy Grounds was picked up by a lot of teams today. If that would have came out in that situation, would have had a nice lock in there. Dignitas could not have been able to escape. So 16-13, Dignitas holding on to their lead, but now we can relax for a little bit and get a bit of a breather. Miracle at the same time hitting 13, and at least finally have a turret on their side.
Yeah, they have that one turret on their side now, but it's still a horrible position for them to be in. Very difficult to go for that objective later on. But I guess Miracle has no other choice anymore. They need to force fight somewhere. They need to make something happen. Get a quick kill, make a rotation, force a battle out of Dignitas. If at any point you get some experience through taking down structures, you might be able to close those gaps. But Dignitas has been running such a tight ship. Look at this, they haven't even lost a single hero. It's 9 kills against 0 in this game.
Just being relentless here, even grabbing this camp to help push in the top lane, trying to get the status quo towards that core, maybe look for a pick. Wubby just throwing out jet propulsions like candy here. It's not even Halloween, but he just tossing them out left and right.
Yeah, and deservedly so. I mean, he gets the value out of them. It's a 2-for-1 Walmart sale they were seeing here the entire time. And with the pressure play topside, Miracle can't even split Heroes off into the middle or bottom to grab more experience. They have to focus their attention on this. There's a double camp pushing in. If you give Dignitas a chance, they will go for core.
Miracle setting up for defense. Potion's already being spread out. Will throw on the ground here. Wubby trying to slow down any target. Sniper drops down a wolf. It connects here right on top of Blaze, but Wubby does not mind.
The shields come out from Tyrael, but is that going to be enough? Again, Wubby with the engage, but he misses. Jet propulsion brings him in deep. The bunker's on the ground right away. There's still a lot of tools available for Miracle, but that three-level lead is making it difficult. Hoik darting in deep, but missing the bomb.
He went in for the pulse bomb. Did not connect. Had that hit. That may have been a kill there on Judy, although he had that sanctification available. Sniper on the backside, also dropping down some Crash Lightnings. Didn't toss the sides. Okay, we didn't get our kill. Let's go ahead and back on up. It was a nice attempt, but we still have a cool 2.5 level advantage on our opponents.
And they forced Miracle to a 5-man defense at the top side, and that just made it impossible for Miracle to split on 3 lanes. So they bought a bit more time. Now the objective is announced. And you look at Miracle and you say, well, there's zero chance that you are getting that 16 immediately. You might have a chance picking it up as Dignitas is adding progress and then go into one fight, but that's the only chance that you're going to get here.
That turret still being focused on the bottom right, but Natsujin in the top had to deal with a Genji who was jumping on him. Natsujin was able to escape, but here's a control point in 2 seconds, and Blaze is already set up to start controlling it. Miracle needs to get this half level of experience and find a fight to where they can actually contest against Dig.
18 for Dignitas. No level 20 in sight anytime soon, but it's all about the level 16 talent here, and Miracle is still half a level away from it. Dignitas with more damage towards the structures, prepping the bottom lane here. Items being picked up by Miracle now. They're trying to at least have some to match what we're seeing on Dignitas. Now Miracle moving in. They don't have 16 yet, but they know that they have a possibility to fight for that protector, and they need to take it.
Miracle stepping up so close to that 16. Sniper in position to come in for a Sundering. Pulse Bomb comes out, but Art of Defender gets used. But that's a cooldown that you're willing to exchange. Meanwhile, Hoik is working on building another Pulse Bomb.
It's do or die. It's now or never. Miracle needs to move in on 16, and they do it. But once again, the Jet Propulsion. Snitch with the damage, looking for the kills. The armor and the shields come out on Miracle's side as they're desperately trying to hold on.
Two Heroics down, though. Sundering used for a counter initiation. Dignitas easily takes the Protector, and now they'll start to look at this bottom lane. They even have the option to go all the way to the top and just take the game. Oh, they're actually going for that option here as they group up and head to the top lane.
Dignitas is just bullying Miracle into this game, and now we have them trying to end it early on. And that's Miracle. They have to somehow move in and try and cut them off here. Dignitas actually is focusing onto the keep right now, realizing that they might not be able to completely pull it off, and instead just trying to get even more of a map advantage. Moving through the middle, but any kill right now would end in an immediate goal for the core.
Oh, Frankel in a weird position here on the back line, getting some damage out. No glove available though, but Frankel helping deal with his protector. At the same time, this keep is getting barraged down. Hoik on the right, keeping everyone in check as Miracle tries to step up and defend.
They will lose the keep. The question is, do they lose more? Is Dignitas able to get a kill here that would lead them to go straight for the end of the game? 19 and a half. They are so close to the Storm Talons. With a 20 advantage, there's no doubt in my mind that Dignitas would go straight for it, but they have to play it a bit safer. They're going for the fort at the bottom lane, and they want that experience.
Two lanes of catapults, top and middle. They're looking to take an extra fort here, which will build towards that level 20. Miracle grouping up, pushing forward. Jet Propulsion comes out. Wubby on that front line. He still has a bunker available if he needs to drop it.
Once again, Poik in the back line trying to go for it. Doesn't find the kill, and the Protector is about to be burned down here. Crash Lightning completed a while ago, so the poke potential is there, but the kill is coming in as Urel falls to JPL.
She had 10 more seconds until she had that Ardent Defender. That cooldown that was used in that bottom control point is going to be exploited by team at Dignitas. Miracle only has 4-4 defense, and Dignitas is grouping up in the middle lane.
I don't even know why they were defending in the first place. That fort is falling no matter what, no matter what you do. Now we might see the end of the game. Snitch goes for Sniper, and they take him down. Sniper dies, and those do the hopes of Miracle to keep it alive, or can they maybe get a counter kill after that amazing stay a while listen?
Big stay a while listen. Snitch goes in straight on top of Blue Beetle, but he'll heal on up. Rainer doing his best to defend. Urel will be back in about 5 seconds to shield. Are up for Miracle. Dignitas pushing the envelope here. Catapults are coming in to help out.
They need an incredible Miracle to stay in this game, but Dignitas is pushing through. JPL low. They want to drop him, but he still has the indestructible. The core is already falling as Miracle is trying desperately to hold on.
JPL on that front side drops on that iron skin. Judy trying to go in with the holy ground, but 20% down to 10. It continues to fall here as Dignitas is going to tie up the series. We're going 1-1, and we're going to game 3 as both teams are tied up in the match.
12-0. Bit of a repetition of what we saw in the first semi-final. Miracle poking the beast here and Dignitas unleashing all their fury in game number two.
I like that team Dignitas slaughters Miracle, comes back on cam, Stitch just like, yeah, what's up? I'm just gonna take it. Business as usual. That had to feel good for team Dignitas to get tie the series back up. And it had to feel good for Genji and for Snitch because it was a risk to let Genji through for that Diablo ban, and Snitch proved he is more than capable of playing it.
A Genji and a Tracer into a Tyrael, you know that you have free roam all day long. We're actually going to take a look at that replay, the big one everybody knows about around that top control point, because, I mean, the key playmakers, I mean, you just watch everything unfold, and this is actually a really good team fight for Miracle. They're on even talent tiers. They want to try and take the fight. So when you watch this, it's all about JPL and Wubby, your two heroes. They're going to be here for Dignitas because it's a matter of them holding point. As we'll move this forward. And when we go forward, they just stay on here. Snitch is in position. By the way, there's four turrets on the side of Dignitas plus the healing emitter. They go through. It's all about holding point. You're going to see a very good route, a very good Stowell, and listen. But if you pause here, you're going to see that there is zero reason. Everything is popped for Miracle. They're ready to go. But it's all about the bunker, and Wubby has such discipline. He pops his Pyromania. You can see he's got the armor. He's going to live in here. He's fine. Dignitas is in so much control. You go forward now, and we have Johanna just holding on point. The whole thing is to wait for Sank, wait for everything to be used. The discipline that they have to withstand this amount of firepower. And the minute that goes forward, Sank is here. Wubby and JPL still have not pressed their buttons yet. But now the minute that starts to roll out, this comes in, Wubby comes out, pause right there. Wubby comes out, hits that, and you can see the X-Strike coming down. That's gonna give it to him right there. So you go forward, and that's just where things exploded. It went from bad to worse for Miracle.
Kind of like that joke and the reference that you continue to try to pull out.
I don't know what you're talking about. But
years
that was
now.
A really, really sick play.
It was sick, it was awesome. And it's awesome for Dignitas. And now I wanna raise a point. When we watched the first series, Liquid versus Gen G, the crowd is going to be on Europe's side, right? They want to see the European teams, and now they've adopted them as NA teams. But Gen G, they're used to the idea of when we come to North America, the crowd may not be as thunderous on our side. For people like Miracle, specifically like Judy, Frankel, Blue Beetle, they're new to this. So how does this affect them going forward?
It definitely affects the play to an extent. I feel like at the beginning of the match or in between, but once you're in your zone and you're focusing on the game itself, you just shrug that off. You can hear it. But at the same time, when they are in the zone in the team fight, I don't think that it really plays as big of a role. But I feel it's more so an aspect in the early stages. And in the early stage of the game, when you still have a lot of time to think and not simply react on instinct, then it can maybe lead to a mistake every now and then.
Anything to add?
Yeah, I think you have a point. If there was going to be any team that was susceptible to it, I think it would be Miracle. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Simply for the mere fact that, because they've mentioned they don't believe they should be here, right? They keep talking about how we're so lucky to be here, where it's great to be here. And while that's wholesome, it's also a position where, like, in the back of your mind, that could become a detriment to you.
Well, they can rely on Sniper and Nacho Gen as these people who bring experience to the team, and they'll be trying to rely on it here. We're going to go to a commercial break, and when we come back, the series continues. See you soon.